Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I am Hamad Yusuf. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa issued Decree Law 21 of 2020 regarding pension funds and insurance and retirement laws and regulations. Under the Decree Law, the Public Sector Retirement Fund regarding the regulation of retirement pensions for government employees and the Social Insurance Fund shall be merged into one fund named the Retirement and Social Insurance Fund. The Pension and Social Insurance Fund shall be overseen by the Social Insurance Organization. The revenues of the Pension and Social Insurance Fund include those previously allocated for the Public Sector Retirement Fund and the Social Insurance Fund in addition to those incurred from the investment of its funds or any other activities. The decree law stipulated that the annual rise in all pensions established under any law, pension or insurance scheme will be stopped. In case of the actuarial report detects a surplus in the Pension of Social Insurance Fund or the Pension Fund for Bahraini and non-Bahraini officers and members of the Bahraini Defense and Public Security Force established by Decree Law 6 of 1991, the surplus will be deposited in a fund this is independent from both funds. The surplus may be used based on the approval of the Supreme Council for Military Retirement and the SIO Board of Directors to increase pensions in a way that would not exceed the increase in the Consumer Price Index and take the situation of retirees with low pensions. The decree law stipulated that retirees are not allowed to receive more than one pension under different retirement and insurance systems, except for those entitled to pensions because of disability, work accidents, or kinship. The pensioners who are entitled to any of the previous laws and get jobs that are not subject to the same law in which they are entitled to the pension may combine their previous service period with their new service period according to the rules stipulated in the retirement and insurance laws and regulations. They may also choose to continue receiving their pensions for their previous work period in addition to the salaries they earn from their new jobs, provided that they are not subject to retirement laws and insurance against work accidents. Employers who fail to pay the insurance contributions stipulated by the social insurance law shall have to pay a fine not less than the total value of the unpaid contributions and not exceeding 3 times its value. The value of the fines shall be referred to the Pension and Social Insurance Fund. His Majesty the King also issued Decree Law 22 of 2020, adding emergency expenditures to the State Budget 2020. The decree law stipulated that an emergency expenditure of 177,360,117 Bahraini dinars will be injected into this year's state budget in order to deal with the emergency expenditures incurred as a result of fighting the coronavirus. His Majesty also issued Decree Law 23 of 2020 on managing part of the funds of the Future Generation Reserve Fund. The decree law stipulated that the deduction from oil revenues embarked for and the account of the FGRF shall be suspended temporarily until the end of the fiscal year 2020, in accordance with the provision of Article 1 of Law 28 of 2006. It also stipulated that an amount of $450 million shall be drawn from the account of the Future Generations Reserve Fund for only once and allocated to supporting the state general budget until the end of the fiscal year 2020 in order to reduce the urgent financial impacts of COVID-19. His Majesty the King also issued Decree Law 24 of 2020, adding a new article to the Law of Associations, Social and Cultural Clubs and Private Bodies operating in the field of youth and sports and private institutions, issued by Decree Law 21 of 1989. His Majesty also issued Decree 25 of 2020, amending some provisions of the Reorganization and Bankruptcy Law in accordance with Law 22 of 2018. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa chaired the cabinet meeting remotely, and Secretary General Yasser al-Nasser made the following statement. The cabinet congratulated His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa for the successful medical checkups he underwent, wishing him lasting good health and happiness. The cabinet then praised the role of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince in leading the National Task Force for combating the coronavirus and hailed the success of the kingdom has achieved in this regard. The cabinet also praised the awareness of citizens and their responsibility in following rules and instructions such as maintaining social distancing and wearing face masks. The cabinet then discussed the latest developments related to COVID-19 and hailed the success of Bahrain in dealing with the pandemic, which gained the recognition of world countries, and also hailed the efforts of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince in this regard. The cabinet then praised the kingdom ranking second place regionally in the UN Indicators Report 2020 in the field of e-government development. The cabinet then denounced the terrorist acts of the Houthi militia on Saudi Arabia and hailed the role of the Arab coalition in foiling these attempts. The Cabinet reviewed and approved a memorandum submitted by the Ministerial Committee for Financial and Economic Affairs and Fiscal Balance on the sustainability of pension funds, which included the recommendations of the Board of Directors of the Social Insurance Organization. It also approved a memorandum which included a recommendation to issue a decree law regarding pension funds in the pension and insurance laws and regulations for emergency reforms. The Cabinet appointed the Ministerial Committee to coordinate with the Board of Directors of the SIO to discuss other urgent reforms in accordance with the recommendations of the organization. The meeting approved the memoranda submitted by the Ministerial Committee for Financial and Economic Affairs and Fiscal Balance on using a part of the Future Generations Reserve Fund by stopping the transfer of oil revenues allocated by the fund temporarily until the end of the fiscal year 2020 and deducting $450 million from the fund for one time only to support the state's general budget during the remainder of the fiscal year 2020. It also approved issuing a decree law on using part of the Future Generations Reserve Fund. The Cabinet approved a draft law on setting control standards and rules that determine the final beneficiary according to the best practices and standards regarding improving international tax compliance, combating money laundering and financing terrorism. Upon the directives of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister to service ministers to visit the Western Area villages, the Cabinet reviewed the results of the visit of the Minister of Electricity and Water Affairs to these villages and their needs as well as listing them in the Ministry's plan to implement them. The Cabinet approved a proposal to develop Rafah Public Library. The Cabinet approved a proposal to include the role of the MP and legislative and supervisory role of the Council of Representatives in the citizenship curriculum. The Cabinet also approved the government's response on a proposal on establishing an athlete museum. The meeting took note on the results of the ministerial meeting of the Arab-Chinese Forum and the results of the participation of the Minister of Labor and Social Development in the regional summit of the International Labor Organization, as well as the results of the meeting of the Council of Ministers of Youth and Sports. The Ministry of Health announced that all travelers arriving into Bahrain International Airport starting Tuesday, July 21, 2020, will be required to shoulder the cost of mandatory COVID-19 testing, which is 30 Bahraini dinars. The Ministry affirmed that it continues to review screening measures on the global response to COVID-19 continues to evolve with the reopening of borders and resumption of international flights. The Ministry emphasized that citizens and residents in Bahrain will continue to be entitled to free COVID-19 medical treatment in line with international standards as outlined by the WHO. Under the decision, cash and electronic payments will be accepted with the option for travelers to pay in advance through the Be Aware Bahrain mobile application to ease proceedings. This decision does not extend to cabin crew, diplomatic or other official travelers, and those arriving from medical travel. Additionally, transit passengers will not be required to test for COVID-19 or quarantine. The ministry added that the civil aviation authorities will coordinate with Bahrain International Airport and airlines on this matter. Travelers who test negative are required to self-isolate for a period of 10 days and test again at the end of their quarantine period at the cost of an additional 30 Bahraini dinars. In this regard, all self-isolating cases are mandated to register on the Be Aware application. The ministry underlined that citizens intending to travel abroad must understand the entry procedures and requirements in place at their chosen destination. They must also sign a declaration form either through the Be Aware app or handwritten prior to departure, agreeing to bear any medical costs incurred while abroad, as well as mandatory COVID-19 testing at their own cost and 10-day self-isolation upon their return to Bahrain. The Ministry of Health said today that the number of coronavirus cases reached 4,408 with 597 recoveries, 471 registered new cases and one death. The Ministry of Health expresses sincere condolences to the family of the deceased. The Ministry urges everyone to adhere to the rules and follow instructions and avoid public places when possible.